Vincent from AirGunsEurope.com, and in this video I'm going to be telling you a bit about the Gammo Replay Magnum. Now, the Replay Magnum is quite an exceptional air rifle, not only because of the fact that it's a high velocity break barrel air rifle, but the combination between the high velocity and the 10x loading system, which is located over here, which basically is a holder which fits on top of the barrel, and in its holder it's got the 10-shot rotary magazine, which is really easy to load. You just push the pellets in like that and then rotate it to the next chamber. It's got an indicator on top showing you how much pellets are left inside the magazine, and when you put a magazine into the loader like that, you only have to break the barrel like this, and there's a small pin inside the holder which pushes a pellet through the magazine into the breech, and then you load it, you simply push it back. You can shoot and you can do it pretty fast. The system works perfect. We've seen this same 10x loading system on the Gammo Swarm, the Gammo Quicker, the Gammo Fast Shell, all using the same system, and it works flawlessly. Really good loading system. But with the Gammo Swarm, the Fast Shot and the Quicker, they're mainly 24 joule air rifles, and this one is a 45 joule air rifle. At least that's what Gammo says. If you would test it, and we did, you would come up to like 38 joules instead of 45, and the muzzle velocity, it is quite high, but not as high as Gammo says, because they say it'll hit up to 360 meters per second, but it doesn't. If you would use like a lead pellet, like the H&N Barracuda or the JSB Exact, which are really good pellets for this air rifle because they're a bit more heavy than the others, it'll hit at around 280 meters per second, which is at around 920 feet per second. So it still is quite powerful, but not as powerful as they say. It's the same with German cars, do it all the time. The gun has got an ambidextrous synthetic stock with a thumb hole on it, so it's got a really nice grip. It's got the manual safety. It also has the cocking safety, so you can only pull the trigger when the barrel is closed. If you open it, you can't pull the trigger. So that's a safety, and this one's manual, so if you want it on safe, you simply push this back, or if you want to shoot, push it forward. Because of the 10x loading system, the gun hasn't got any open sights on it, so you would have to shoot with a scope, and luckily the gun comes with a scope, a pretty good one as well. The scope has got, you can zoom it in from 3 up to 9 times. It's got a 40mm objective, and it's located on a recoil reduction rail to give it a little less stress when shooting the air rifle, because it'll give you some recoil and you don't want the scope to break. It's got the custom action trigger on it, so it's two-way adjustable. The weight is 3.1 kilograms. The length is 121 centimeters long. It's 47.5 inches long. So it's quite a long air rifle, but it's good balanced and it's not that heavy, so it's really fun to shoot all day. Yeah, let's give it a try. Okay, so to load it and to get the magazine out, you just simply push this release button. It comes out like that, and now you can load it. Simply put some pellets in, turn it to the other chamber, and another one goes in. It's really easy to load. Alright, so I just put in some. It says 4 on top, so you know there's 4 pellets inside the magazine. Simply push it back into place, click, and that's it. Now when you cock the air rifle, it's really good to put it inside your hip, because the cocking effort is quite heavy. Load it like that, and now there's a little pin which pushes a pellet inside the barrel. Push it back, now it says 3, so there's 3 left inside the magazine, and 1 in the barrel, of course. Yeah, it packs quite a punch. And you can do that quite fast after each other. I haven't really calibrated the scope yet, and maybe, as you can see, the pellets are coming way too low. But that's quite easy. Simply turn this off. And now over here it says up counterclockwise. All the pellets are coming down way too low, so I just simply turn up. like that, and now it should do a little bit better. It says one over here, so there's one left inside the magazine. Probably should be the last one. And that's better. Always make sure it's empty, of course, but it is. Comes with one magazine. They don't wear out or anything like that, but they're easily replaceable. Really nice air rifle. Works perfectly, comes with a really nice scope, and it's a full power air rifle. If you would want to buy this, you could just simply order it online on our website, www.airgunseurope.com, and yeah, we always have it on stock. Alright, see you next time!